Hello, my artsy friends. Welcome back to the Art Playground. Today, I want to do something with an ombre type background. For many places, it is the beginning of Pride Month, so I've got out the new WOW colors, and I've kind of sort of put them in the array of a rainbow, just so I can include them all. I might not use them all, but for now, they are there. I pulled out some of my older greeting cards that I did and digital stamps, and I just thought I would be inspired by some old work. I have just recently lost a friend, and so I thought I would just kind of do this as a little tribute to him. And I was going through some of my digital stamps, my older ones, and my little unicorn girl here, excuse me, we have lots of cotton in the air, she jumped out at me, and he himself was a unicorn. He was fabulous, so I thought I would be inspired by her and create a new version and invite you along to join in with me. So here we go. This is my Stillman and Birn journal. And some of the past creations I did using the WOW products. A lot of Alice. So I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to create like an ombre background here. And then I'm going to do the character, the girl, on a separate piece of paper and cut her out and attach her in here. So let's get started. I have out I grabbed my new Jane Davenport paints. They are her layer cakes and they're nice and bright, so I thought they would be fun. The neons are very neon. I think I'm going to use this one, the rainbow cake. How apropos. So if you have these paints, just so you know, you do need to seal your page after because they will rub back off the page. I'm not soaking the page, I'm just doing a light spritz. We want to get it all wet. I'm not a rainbow guru. I could not tell you to save my life. I think the purple goes on top. Let's just do it that way. Let's go for it. Let's feel the paint. Since I spritz my page, it's all going to kind of emerge like that, and that is what I want. I want it to be somewhat organic and free. I want it to be solid silver, but I kind of want to give the hint of like a background, and that will be an area that we can write on as well. Just going to let that dry. I'm going to dab that little part up a little bit. Okay, so now that your page is all dry, you can start thinking about the stamps or doodles you want to do in here and the embossing powders. So I'm going to do a whole bunch of little hearts, and then I'm going to use the love stamp down here at the bottom by Verity Beetlecomb from WOW. And I'm going to have it off to the side because I know my character is probably going to be around here in the colors. So, and then the purple, the lavender, I'm going to use the sugared almond. So we're going to do petalicious WS-288R on the next one. I'm going to do the pinkish one next inside the red. That one is Candy Floss, WS-299R. That one is Touch of Lemon. I'm going to use some of these sentiments on the curves. This one says Always and Forever. going to use the Twiggy. There's another one that says, with all my heart. Fresh Stem WL58R. You could even just leave your journal page like this. You can journal all in the open areas. This is one of my favorite quotes from a movie called The Knight's Tale, or A Knight's Tale. Missing you in all the pieces of my broken heart. Before I stick him down, let us quickly grab some sparkles. Golden acrylic glazing liquid in satin. That's the Gold Rush, SPRK032. And then me, a version of me. Missing you. I did a whoops on the G, but it still works. Missing you with all the pieces of my broken heart. With all my heart, always and forever, and love. In the stamp set. So I hope you guys enjoyed that. I know it was a little different. But it's to show you that art can help you heal. So embrace it, be creative, use some art supplies, fill your bucket, find some joy, and go play. And I will see you guys in the next video. Thank you very much for joining me. Bye bye for now.